This is our locking amplifier. I shall explain the various controls and buttons on the locking amplifier as I go along. We should first calibrate the locking amplifier. What does this mean? It means we should give known AC signals of known voltage and see what is the maximum DC output we get. So once we know the relation between the AC input and DC output, we say we have calibrated the lock-in. Any unknown AC will give a DC output which we will measure. From the calibration, we can find the unknown AC voltage. So what we do is, we apply a known weak signal and measure the maximum DC output of the lock-in amplifier. This is what we do to calibrate the lock-in. You will see two switches at the top of the lock-in. You will see two switches at the top of the lock-in. You have to put them inwards towards the point marked calibration. So for calibration, put these two switches inwards. There is an RCA plug at the right bottommost plug, this one, you connect it to the signal generator. You switch on the signal generator, set a frequency of 1 kHz and peak to peak amplitude of 11 volts. The signal generator panel meter gives peak to peak amplitude VPP. Normally a DMM measures VRMS. So VRMS is VPP divided by 2 root 2. This applied voltage here will send a current through 3 resistors to 20k, 10 ohms and 5k connected in series inside the box. To 20k, 10 ohms, 5k in series, the applied voltage will send a current IRMS which is VRMS divided by sum of the 3 resistances, which is 225,010 ohms. So 1 by 225,010 is 4.44 into 10 power minus 6. So the current is 4.44 VRMS microampere. If VRMS is 1 volt, IRMS is 4.44 microampere. If it is 2 volts, it is 8.88 microamperes. The weak AC signal, which will give me the DC voltage, is obtained from the voltage across 10 ohms. So the voltage across 10 ohms is 10 into 4.44 VRMS microvolts, that is 44.4 VRMS microvolt. So you know VPP, you calculate VRMS, multiply it by 44.4, that is my AC signal in microvolts. The reference is the voltage across 5K. It should be above a few millivolts. That is the only requirement. You can put 5K, 10K, whatever you want here. Note that the same current, IRMS e power I omega t, passes through 10 ohms and 5K. So V will vary as e to the power of I omega t. V reference, which is the voltage across 5K, will also vary as e to the power of I omega t. So signal and reference are in phase. We connect a DMM to read the DC voltage in the range 2000 millivolts. We connect it to the RCA plug marked output. That reads 887 millivolts. There are two RCA plugs here, the green and the gray. The bottom one is marked reference and this one is marked reference dashed. Actually, the reference voltage comes to the phase shifter. The output of the phase shifter is reference dashed. And phase can be adjusted by turning this pot. When the pot is at the right end, there is no phase shift. That means reference and reference dash are in phase. They are connected to two channels of this oscilloscope. And if I press the button main, you will see the AC signal due to reference and reference dash. They are falling on top of each other. I will shift one of them. I will shift one of them up. You can now see the yellow and the blue traces match. The maximum of the yellow falls on the maximum of the blue. Minimum of the yellow falls on the minimum of the blue. They are in phase. Now look what happens when I turn this pot. You now see that the blue, which is the phase shifted reference, is moving to the left relative to the yellow. The maximum of the blue is shifted away from the maximum of the yellow. We are generating a phase difference between reference and reference dash. This can be seen if I put the oscilloscope in the XY mode. When this pot is at the right end, I don't give any phase shift. I apply the reference voltage along the x-axis, the reference dashed voltage along y, and the electron moves in a direction which is a straight line, 45 degrees to the x-axis. When I turn the phase shifter, the electron moves along an ellipse, indicating that there is a phase difference between the x and y voltages. As I increase the phase difference, the ellipse becomes a circle. And if I increase it further, circle becomes an ellipse with the major axis in the second quadrant. Now see what happens to the DC output. The DC output is 888 millivolts as I introduce a phase difference coming down. Why? Because I will get a maximum output when reference dash and signal are in phase. But already signal and reference are in phase. So reference dash must be in phase with reference to get maximum output, and that will happen when I don't phase shift. So when this line is a straight line, I will get the maximum DC output. In the lock-in amplifier, we must always adjust the phase shifting part to get maximum DC output. This happens in the present case when the pot is in the extreme right position and the figure and the oscilloscope is a straight line. So we note VPP from the signal generator and VDC. From VPP, we calculate VRMS. So we have our VRMS. From VRMS, we calculate the AC signal in microvolt, that is 44.4 times VRMS. Then we change the peak-to-peak voltage from 11 to 3 volts in steps of 2 volts. And we note the DC voltage. Then so I start with a frequency 500 Hz. I calculate the RMS voltage from the peak to peak voltage, which is given in the first column. From this RMS voltage, I calculate the signal voltage 44.4 into 1.03, 44.4 into 1.51. And the output DC voltage I note here, and I do this for 500, 1000, 1500 Hz up to 3000 Hz. Then I plot a graph between the output DC voltage and the signal voltage in microvolts. This is for 500 Hz. The points fall on a straight line. Slope of the line is 5.35 into 10 power 3. I do it for all these frequencies and note the slope. You see that the slope varies from 5.21 to 5.48, 5% when I change the frequency. So I will take the average value and take it as a constant value of mu, which is the amplification factor, DC output by RMS AC signal. This is calibration.